This SUV TV presentation of Holiday Hoopsgiving is brought to you by Adidas, East Bay, Children's Healthcare of Atlanta, The Oaks Course, The Atlanta Tip-Off Club.
We welcome you in courtside to Holy Innocence as SUV TV's exclusive coverage of the 5th anniversary Holiday Hoopsgiving continues. It is Wasatch Academy taking on the Meadowcreek Mustangs. Meadowcreek out of Georgia, Wasatch out of Utah. I'm Joel Hillsman, and my partner out of Virginia is Lewis Preston. Coach Preston, we've seen this Meadowcreek team. We've seen this Wasatch Academy team here. Trey Williams, what he does with the basketball, I'll talk about it.
He does a little bit of everything. Let's just call it like it is. There's a reason why he's going to the Big Ten. Love how he plays inside out. Once again, does everything. As we talk about Meadowcreek, though, defensively, it'll be interesting to see how Mr. Williams, how he can handle the different defensive alignments that Meadowcreek's going to throw at him today.
And we know that they are going to come with a bevy of defensive alignments. Curtis Gillian in his third year at Meadowcreek, they are known for defense. Last year they did it on the back line. This time they're doing it more so on the wings and active and playing faster. Last year they used to like the whole teams under 50 points. Wasatch, they can score and they can go. I think right now it may be defensive stops in the end or timely defensive stops.
And the one great thing about this game is there's two different styles. And with these two different styles, you're going to see which style comes to the surface and is able to take over, especially in late game situations.
Wasatch Academy out of Mount Pleasant, Utah. Beautiful, beautiful scenic area out in Utah as they have their starting lineups adduced. It'll be number one, Marvin Williams III, officially known as Trey Williams. Number three, Mike Saunders. Number five, Bernardo Del Silva. Number 13, Tristan Enriquardo. And number 44, Maddie Sisisco. So it'll be Williams, Saunders, Del Silva, Enriquardo, and Sisisco, your starters for the Wasatch Academy. For Meadowcreek, it'll be number three, Jalen Benjamin. Number four, Damian Dunn. Number 12, Jamani Watkins-Causey. Number 24, Jameer Chaplin. And number 25, Emmanuel Collier. Once again, it'll be Benjamin, Dunn, Watkins-Causey, Chaplin, and Emmanuel Collier. Both teams coming in at 3-0. Meadowcreek will be all in white, white tops, white bottoms, trimmed in Columbia blue. The numbers are in white, but they're trimmed in that Columbia baby blue. Wasatch Academy, their head coach is David Evans, and they'll be coming out all in black, black tops, black bottoms, and they've got the orange numbers, very much looking like a October 31st Halloween uniform.
Oh, they're missing a little bit of royal blue to have some of the Gator black uniform.
Understood that one, too. Hey, how about that?
I know.
He's Lewis Preston, former assistant and national championship winning coach at Florida. That's why he broke that out right quick.
I had to bring that out for you.
I'm Joe Hillsman. Glad that you are with us right here from Holy Innocence Episcopal School in Atlanta, Georgia. Meadowcreek out of Georgia. Wasatch Academy out of Utah. Wasatch, 143-year-old private boarding school out there in Mount Pleasant. And they know how to play in April at Geico, two-time Geico quarterfinalist the past 2016 and 2017 season.
Wow. Says a lot about Coach Evans and his ability to coach his group up and get them better as the season goes along.
Oh, Coach, you didn't know that?
Now I do. Now I do.
Let's get ready to rumble. I like the DJ playing that here. Got a new reffing crew, officiating crew. I think this one's going to be all right.
The ones we had the previous two games were very good as well. I just want to make sure that that's known, considering that I'm the referee hater in Georgia.
Underway. Wasatch Academy wins the tip. Wasatch opening a corner three. It is good. Trey Williams gets the party started with a corner three.
Trey Williams is just doing and leaving off where he was at yesterday. Makes the game look easy.
Benjamin open a three. Good. Right back at you, Jalen. Benjamin a three ball. So we exchange triples as this one begins.
Basically, whatever you can do, I can do better.
The Tigers and the Mustangs. Catch it and hold it back. De Silva lost it around. It will stay with Wasatch. Saunders goes to take the ball out of bounds. Baseline out of bounds. Mike Saunders looks, and gets it in. And Sissoko now to Evan. At the Sissoko. Put it on the floor. Long striding across the lane. No good. Tipped out of bounds, and it will go to Meadowcreek after the change of possession.
Great defense right there.
This is very big for Meadowcreek. Mm-hmm. We know they won the first Georgia State Championship last season. They're the defending 7A champ. But they don't get to go and travel much. The out-of-state was very, very limited, even though they played a very good in-state schedule.
Right.
So this is a good test of where they would be on the national barometer of things.
Mm-hmm.
Here's Benjamin. Benjamin passes tipped away. Sissoko. And they're doing it against a team that everybody knows. Don't let them being in Utah fool you. It's a private boarding school. Williams, corner three. Good. Back-to-back corner threes from Trey Williams. He's going to shoot it from Utah and take it to Minnesota.
Bro, I'm going to tell you this right now. You got to get him out that corner because he's sprinting down there knowing that that's his sweet spot.
Benjamin across the timeline. He's worked on defensively by Saunders. Gives it over. Both teams coming in at 3-0. Both of them won their contest yesterday in day one of Hoopsgiving action. Done. No good. Rebound comes off. Outletting now to Sissoko. Sissoko now gives it down. They're going to go baseline. He shut him off. He wanted to go in Warnio. Tristan now spins it back out to Mike Saunders, who sets it up. Williams sees it, and he goes back the other way. Sissoko caught it. Oh, he took off running like a tight end with a pass and a turnover.
You always got to make that football reference in this state, huh?
He's a big boy, though, Coach.
He
caught that, like a tight end. Oh, I see Douglas Bird sitting across the way on Coach's row.
You know Douglas Bird was going to make his way over here.
Benjamin gives it to Chaplin. Chaplin's first touch. The Dunn now worked on by Williams, and he spins it back to Benjamin, now over to Collier. Collier spins it, and now here's Benjamin. Jalen Benjamin worked on by Saunders. He has a count on him. Left-hand dribble. Got him to fall down, but he kept up. Now he's got the mismatch out high. Sissoko, they're trying to go down low to Damani Watkins. He's going to get a 3 second.
You got the mismatch, Jalen.
Chaplin goes baseline and
goes.
Jamir Chaplin with a baseline jam. He rolls up and dunked it home.
And that is what the South Florida signee brings to this team right there, a little bit of everything.
Oh beautiful goodness. Spin move. Bernardo Da Silva with his first field goal.
Wow, a nice spin move right there.
8-5, 5:15 to go. Coach Curtis Gillian in his third season won the state championship at Meadowcreek in his second year. 7A, the highest classification. Nobody saw it coming from Meadowcreek of people that are surprised. Yes, they are good. They're that good again this year. Chaplin drives, takes contact and scores. So Jameer Chaplin now with 4 points.
That's a great move by Chaplin right there. He did his spin move the same way De Silva did his spin move.
Drive up, Saunders lost it, and it comes out.
Keep going.
Drive and score, Jalen Benjamin out of Kingston, North Carolina. He has 5 points in the contest.
I'll tell you one thing. When we get to the next timeout, there's something to talk about right there with the way Jameer Chaplin setting those screens right there. When that defensive player gets up on the high side, he should automatically slip to the basket. That whole area is wide open for the slip. Wow. big fella right there, De Silva, with that nice finish.
Yeah, Bernardo De Silva with a nice move. He scored 10-9, so we swing the pendulum back and forth. All right, so now here's Benjamin. Benjamin holding now. That's done. Done now to Chaplin at the top. Open three. Chaplin shoulder range. Okay. Jameer Chaplin has came to play right now with 7 early points in this first quarter and showing the range.
Jameer trying to let everybody know in the country what Meadowcreek basketball is all about.
No, get this shot out of here. Jameer Chaplin will get hit by the block.
He's come ready to play. He has come ready to play.
And a timeout call. Coach Curtis Gillian calls the timeout. I don't know why he want to kill good momentum. But as we take a look at our SCV TV instant replay, Jameer Chaplin, you mentioned, come to play. 7 points and now a beautiful beat down block as we take a look at our SCV TV instant replay. And B-roll coming on Jameer Chaplin now. And while we do that, we'll remind you of the Atlanta Tip-Off Club. The Atlanta Tip-Off Club annually recognizes the top high school and college players, coaches, and officials and administrators in Metro Atlanta and the state of Georgia. Join the ATOC, nominate players and coaches, or learn more at www.ATLTipOffClub.com. New coaches mention SUV TV when you sign up to receive 10% off of your season membership. Meadowcreek will be in the Tournament of Champions. I got to see him earlier this week in the Jared Cook Tip-Off Classic. They had to pull away from Dekula and went ahead, and they put on a dunk fest in that fourth quarter. DeSilva catches it and walks. Right.
One of the things I'm concerned about from Meadowcreek is can they neutralize Wasatch Academy's size as this game continues to go? Because one of the things, you look at Wasatch, they're trying to get that ball inside to Sissoko as well as DeSilva.
And also, they're trying to blow you out with numbers. Mm-hmm. We're talking about the contrasting styles. Meadowcreek defensively, the contrast of Wasatch early on, early sample size, they're averaging 91 points a game. They want to get up and down the floor.
Exactly. So this game is in Meadowcreek's favor right now with the tempo and everything.
Very much so. 12 to 10, a drive. Benjamin scores. Jalen Benjamin and Jameer Chaplin right now have the party started for the Mustangs. 14 to 10, here come the Tigers and Mike Saunders. Saunders dribble now, spins it to the right side. They catch it coming off that screen. That's Tristan. Trout. Tristan shoveled it over. Now to Williams. Down low, Sissoko. Back over. Tristan, open corner. Three. It's off. No. Rebound. Jump ball. Possession arrow. We'll go to Meadowcreek.
Great defensive rotation right there by Meadowcreek. I've said it once. I'll say it 1,000 times. I'll argue with anybody in the state of Georgia. Meadowcreek is the best half-court defensive team and how they align and rotate in the state of Georgia.
Kedrick Green now into the contest off of the Meadowcreek bench. He will be the sixth man of the year if he stays in that capacity. Gives it to Chaplin. Chaplin worked on by Tristan. Now pops to the top now to Watkins-Causey. Watkins-Causey hands it to Benjamin. Benjamin turns, fires a three, bottom. Jalen Benjamin is on fire in his first quarter. He now has 10. It is 17 to 10. Meadowcreek, a booming 7-point lead on Wasatch Academy. Saunders might have to get it going. He's worked on by Green. Saunders drive, layup short, foul call.
Called that foul a little bit late right there.
And the Meadowcreek faithful behind us are ecstatic.
Hey, not only does the Meadowcreek team bring the intensity on the court, the fan base behind us brings the intensity.
Listen, Meadowcreek is the school is good. Athletic programs have had talent. They hadn't had a lot of success and support. Soccer got a state championship. Football made the playoffs for the first time in I don't know how long and then advanced. And now the basketball team with a state championship, you're going to hear a little noise from them.
Absolutely. Well-deserved noise.
Mike Saunders' first free throw good. Second free throw is good. 17 to 12. 2.5 to go first quarter. Green brings it across the timeline. Went right by the trap. Green going to go all the way. Kick it to the corner. Open three. Bang! A three ball by Emmanuel Collier. And now David Evans, I think, hit with a warning.
He was hit with a warning.
Warning on David Evans. I don't know what he didn't like, because Kedrick Green been doing that to a lot of people. Drive and kick, and the three ball was there in the corner. Here's Sissoko. Down low. Kick it. They're going to drive. Tristan, cross court, open corner three, off the bench into the scorebook. Strip the Nets, a three ball by Richie Sunder.
It's a high level of basketball being played on both ends right here, and this is what we expected here at Holiday Hoopsgiving.
You like how Coach Evans goes to the bench and brings in the sniper who immediately stymies that little run. Foul called on Saunders as he fouled Kedrick Green as he came across the timeline. Green will be the trigger man. Green looks. Green looks. And gets it in a done. Dunn now catches it. Worked on by Williams. Fakes, pull up, jumper. Here it is off to the left. And Chaplin flew in and got the rebound, but it's bounced off. Here comes Williams. Williams in the break. Williams, Euro stepping to the hoop. Driving and scoring. Ooh. Trey Williams.
That's what Trey Williams does, being able to score at all three levels. He made that look really easy right there.
He has eight. Excuse me, Coach, for stepping on you. Now coming across, here's Benjamin. Benjamin boom dribbling on that logo. Give it to Dunn. Dunn lost it. They go fighting and diving on the floor. Sissoko recovers the fumble. I'm sorry, Sissoko looks like a tight end. I done gave him a tight end call, and now I done gave him a fumble recovery.
Wow.
Wrong score.
I'm telling you.
I did have double duty yesterday, but, I know.
You must have been paying attention to that Georgia Tech score.
I have not seen it. It's been a basketball state of mind for me. Here's Williams now, worked on by Dunn. Shot it into Sissoko. Sissoko, 14-footer. It is short. Badly missed. Rebound comes off to Richie Saunders. Turns, fires, guns it home. Richie Saunders sniping off the bench.
Boy, he then came in back-to-back threes right there to make it a tie game.
Boom, boom, boom.
That's what I'm saying.
8-0 run, just like that. Green gives it to Chaplin. Chaplin holding between the rings. We're under a minute to go. Sissoko has it. Now he gives it back to Benjamin. Benjamin picked up by Saunders out on the Holiday Hoopsgiving logo. Screen comes to the right. Benjamin shovels it, and it's a steal by Richie Saunders. Saunders back to Mike Saunders. Saunders on the break. Saunders and Saunders Incorporated score on the break.
10-0 run right now by Wasatch to take a 22-20 lead.
Benjamin back quickly, and offensive foul called on Jalen Benjamin. I didn't see it myself. Coach Gillian didn't see it, but either way, you mentioned it is a 10-0 run right now for Wasatch Academy. They were trailing 20-12.
Ever since Coach Evans got that warning, they've been on that 10-0 run.
Pretty much that came at 2:13. Richie Saunders, a pair of threes. Williams, a hoop. And Mike Saunders, a hoop. There's your 10 points right there. Mike Saunders across the timeline, picked up by Benjamin. Blows by him with the left hand, all the way left. Good with the right hand, Mike Saunders. Saunders coming in, averaging right at 9 points per game on the season. And he drops it in there about three dimes. So right now, it's a 12-0 run. 5 seconds, Benjamin dribbling. Does he see the clock? One, Benjamin drives. Get it out. No. End of the first quarter. It now has a 12-0 run for Wasatch to end it. They lead Meadowcreek 24-20. You're watching exclusive coverage of Holiday Hoopsgiving 5th anniversary on SUV TV.
Heels or flats?
Heels. Around here, we're decision-making pros. But when she got injured last season, I almost made the wrong decision. I thought I could take her where I rehabbed my knee. But her coach told me, take her to Children's. No thanks. All that experience helped my daughter heal faster and come back stronger.
Now we just need to decide where I'll play in college.
Road trip.
Wasatch Academy, a 12-0 run to close the first quarter, and they lead Meadowcreek 24-20. We welcome you back inside Holiday Hoopsgiving at Holy Innocents Episcopal School in Atlanta. Driving Williams, he goes and will get fouled, and the foul will be called on Jamani Watkins Causey. Quickly, Coach, looking at some first quarter numbers. Wasatch shooting 64% from the field. Meadowcreek shooting 72% from the field.
I've never seen a team shoot 72% and be down by four. Just tells you just how impressive both of these teams are offensively, because the differentiator right here in the first quarter was Richie Saunders coming off the bench with that bang, bang, back-to-back threes. Helped start that 12-0 run.
10 points in the paint, and Williams hit the first free throw, second one coming up, back iron, he split them, they tip, they fight for the rebound, and it comes off, they'll get a second chance opportunity, but now there's a turnover. 25-20, Wasatch Academy entering the contest 3-0 under David Evans, and they're out of Mount Pleasant, Utah. I spent some time in Salt Lake and Logan, Coach.
I have too, also in Provo.
Yeah. I mean, beautiful scenery. They don't have. I was on the interstate there, and you have that wonderful, majestic mountain view. And I didn't see a speed limit sign for I don't know how far. And then I saw one, and it said 75.
Right.
And I didn't slow down, just like Williams didn't slow down in transition, but he'll get hit with the offensive foul.
That's a great job by Keidre Green right there. But once again, Jameer Chaplin was on that trail. Even if he hadn't gotten the charge call, he was going to return that to sender.
25-20. He's Lewis Preston. I'm Joel Hillsman. Glad that you're with us. Courtside at SUV TV, wherever you are. Watch SUVTV.com has you covered. They get it inside. Here's Dunn. Dunn turns, being patient. Now he's going to turn. Shoot jumper, Damian Dunn. His first points of the contest.
That's a tough shot. It went in. That's a tough shot right there by Dunn.
25-22. Second chance points after a quarter in favor of Wasatch Academy. 5-0. And they have 10 points off of four turnovers. And one, Mike Saunders. He'll get a shot now at the free throw line. Saunders, 2 of 2 on the day from the line. He'll get one more now to try and complete the three-point play to Hardaway.
Foul was on Chaplin right there.
Jameer Chaplin picked up the foul. Free throw, no good. They tip, fight for it. And a foul will be called on Wasatch Academy, and it'll be on Sissoko. Maddie Sissoko picked up the foul. Wasatch plays in the Utah High School Activities Association, the UHSAA.
Go, Jameer, pop, Jameer,
Benjamin
pop.
Gives it over to Dunn. Dunn left with space, pump fake, put it on the floor. There's a drive and score, Damian Dunn. A beautiful move, and Coach, you like to talk about next-level plays. He's going to Temple. Next-level play right there. One dribble. He makes his move and scores.
Damian Dunn is an absolute steal for the Temple Owls. Another Georgia Peach leaving the state.
Now, push by Kedrick Green and a foul. We've talked about Kedrick Green on SUV TV, but to you all nationally, we're going to introduce you to him. He came off the bench at this point last year. Took over as the starting point guard in February. In Georgia in February, that's playoff time. Region tournament, state championship, and he guided them to a state championship victory. Oh, man, you will call your sent away. He got the steal. Williams got the block. They fight for it on the floor, scrapping. Sissoko down there, I got it, and a timeout. I love it, Coach. They're diving and scrapping and falling all over the hardwood.
He's got to give that ball up to Don on the trail for that easy dunk right there in a two-on-one situation.
At Children's Healthcare of Atlanta, the sports medicine team doesn't just treat the pain from sports injuries. They work with young athletes to fix the problem and teach them proper sports mechanics. When you choose Children's, you're in the hands of specialists who understand how to help young athletes get back in the game. Visit choa.org/sportsmed to learn more. Joel Hillsman, Lewis Preston, glad that you're with us. Courtside, Wasatch Academy, 3-0. Meadowcreek, 3-0. Meadowcreek out of Georgia, Wasatch out of Utah, but it's a private school. They're a 143-year-old boarding school, and they like to go to New York at the end of March. Two quarterfinal appearances, 2016-2017, in a Geico Nationals, formerly known as Dick. So Coach Evans and this squad, the program at Wasatch, very much deserving of the trip here to Holiday Hoopsgiving. They have a three-point lead in possession, and Benjamin and Saunders has it. He's worked on by Benjamin, Mike Saunders. With the right-hand dribble, bout high. They're trying to give it to Saunders coming off that screen. Richie, catch, five, sniper, Bob, back iron, no. Rebound comes off to Jalen Benjamin. 2 minutes gone, second quarter. Benjamin across the timeline gets the screen from Chaplin. Worked on defensively now by Williams. Here comes Watkins, calls it to give him the screen. Says Osco showed on it. Benjamin steps into a three-ball bottom. Strips the net. Jalen Benjamin off the screen. He has 13 points.
Kind of reminds me of what he did out during the exclusive run back in the summer.
27-27. So Williams gives it back. Tristan open three. Back iron. No. Fight for the rebound. Sissoko comes away with it. And Kendrick Green, the young sophomore, stole it away. Green now across the timeline. Lost pass to Chaplin and scores. Kendrick Green seeking and finding and a finish there by Jameer Chaplin. He has nine.
And he got the M one. It is a beautiful high level game of basketball being played right now here at Holy Innocents.
The pinpoint passing by Kendrick Green to Jameer Chaplin. Jameer going to the free throw line to try and complete the three-point play. He has nine in the game.
I'm surprised some football coaches haven't reached out to Kendrick Green.
No, he's a hooper. He's a hooper.
I'm just saying.
He's a hooper.
This is your state.
He a hooper. He a hooper. It may be my state, but I'm a basketball guy. It's just where I just look like this. Free throw, good. I told you I spent some time in Utah. Don't make me start dropping all them nuggets on you now, because jazz games are fun.
Yeah.
Before, during, and after. Here's Williams. Williams going to drive, dump it off to Sissoko. He walked. The rim blocked his shot. Rebound comes off to Richie Saunders, and a foul called on Watkins Causey. That'll be his second. He must be easy with it. That'll be his second foul. Now, that's one of the things for Meadowcreek this year. Hightower is gone.
Kelly
is gone. Kelly at Duquesne, Hightower at Presbyterian. That was 6'8 and 6'10 that you're losing. Watkins Causey, 6'6. You now has to go to the bench. Now you have to go heavy guards. Collier, Green, Benjamin, Chaplin, and Dunn. The five on the floor, your small ball.
And that's where I said that this is where Wasatch's size could be a factor in regards to this game.
Free throw good from Richie Saunders. I would not let Richie Saunders out of my sight
at all
if I was Meadowcreek. He shot the lights out yesterday in their blowout victory over Legacy Early College out of Greenville, South Carolina. Free throw good. He made them both. He has 8 points. 30-29. Meadowcreek in possession in the white. They've got the 30. Wasatch has got the 29. It has been a very, very well-played game. Benjamin a three. No, Sissoko gets the rebound. He outlets it now. Gives it to Tristan. Tristan gets it up ahead. And here is Williams. Williams around the screen from Sissoko. 15-foot floater. It rolled off. Tip follow. Good. On the back off of, that's going to be Leonardo Comero who comes in and gets the hoop.
Comero did a great job of staying active on the glass and getting that nice little tip in right there.
Comero with a beautiful move as he got that tip back in. 31-30, we flip-flop as 3 minutes have gone now in the second quarter. Kendrick Green now on the left wing. They're looking to run it. Pops it out to Benjamin. They closed out on him. Benjamin going to drive and a foul call. And let's see, will it be on Richie? If it's on Richie Saunders, that's going to be his second. Yeah, Richie Saunders not too fouled now.
That kind of hurts him because he's came off with 8 nice points for Wasatch right there.
8 beautiful nice points. Inbound. Chaplin goes up. Count it. And the fire. Jameer Chaplin with the left-hand lay. Living right got the roll.
I tell you, he's going to go down to USF for Brian Gregory. And he's going to do some great things down there, down in Tampa. Got to give props to Larry Dixon for coming up here and getting another Georgia Peach.
Chaplin at the free throw line. It is good. Jameer Chaplin now back-to-back three-point plays. Two-point lead, 33-31, 4:44 to go. Saunders remains on the floor. Didn't use the screen. Green went reaching in. Now he's back between the rings and gives it to Williams. Williams with a boom dribble now brings it up to Sissoko. Sissoko holds cross-court to Mike Saunders. Mike, long pass back to Williams. Pump fake, put it on the floor, escape dribble, throw it, jumper, good, nice move.
That's a high-level move right there, fellas.
Even at 33, and then a steal, and Saunders comes back and cracks. Is it a three or
it's
two?
A three.
It's a three, all right. I was shielded by the ref. He's got three of those triples. And just like that, 36-33, they hit him with 5 quick points. They had a 12-0 run to end the first. Are they going to 1-1 here? Halfway gone, done. Kips it, Green, open three. No, rebound ripped off high by Sissoko. Sissoko to start. Oh, he double dribbled. They didn't call it. Gives it up to Williams. Marvin Williams III, affectionately known as Trey Hazard. He's trapped in the corner. Step through. Gives it to Mike Saunders. Mike back over to Richie Saunders. They're closing out on him quickly. Might be too late. Open corner three. Williams bottoms. They are bombing from distance.
Wow.
39-33. Don't go get up and get anything right now till halftime. 3:30 to go. Benjamin fouls. Saunders hit with the foul. SUV TV instant replay.
It's so fast. Bang, bang, bang.
That's how basketball is supposed to be played, right?
Exactly.
Oh, okay, I'll just check.
Can somebody please get Trey Williams out of the corners? Can we do that?
Somebody needs to get him out of somewhere. And Richie Saunders, you might want to watch him too. Richie Saunders out of Riverton, Utah, 6'5", junior, and he's shooting it from Riverton right now.
I'm telling you, he got a beautiful stroke.
Benjamin hits the first free throw. Benjamin hits the second free throw. Benjamin out of Kingston, North Carolina. 39-35, 3.5 to go. Can we play 10-minute quarters in the second half? I would be okay with that.
So would I.
Spins it to the left. Mike Saunders holds it. Now he pops it to Williams. Williams between the rings. Worked on by Chaplin. Gets the screen. Pass was deflected by Dunn. Recovered. Oh, Richie. Oh, Richie. Give me the hot sauce. Give me the hot sauce, Richie Saunders.
Gotta make him a
His
drive.
Fourth triple of the day. A 7-point game. 42-35. Richie Saunders is seeking flames off the bench. I just looked over at Jonas Hayes. I think he just wrote down his name on the notes tab in his phone.
Think he's going to be on a flight out to Wasatch next week.
That's right. Riverton, Utah's way from. Goes baseline. Good ball movement. Green skipped it off to Benjamin. Benjamin got caught underneath the basket. Comes back out. Probes back in. Volleyballed out of there by Sissoko. And Richie Saunders recovers it. Gets it over to Mike Saunders. Saunders is in transition. Saunders going to drive all the way. Layup it rolled off. Sissoko got the board. Put it up and in and scored. The size is going to be a problem for Meadowcreek.
Said it. I said it to begin the second quarter, especially when they got that second foul.
9-point ball game. Maddie Sissoko out of West Africa. Technically, they list him at 6'9". I think they're being generous. He might be 7 feet. Green trapped. The pass deflected. And a steal and a foul by Chaplin. And all of a sudden, right now, I think Coach G may have to burn a timeout. I know he doesn't like it. Both teams in the bonus shooting free throws the rest of the way. You don't see this from Kendrick Green often here with the poor decision and a turnover.
Right. He dribbled down to that coffin corner right there and got trapped. So was there anything more he could do with that? Chaplin got his second foul too right there, right?
Yes. Corey Blessed now has checked into the contest now. You're going to have to try to steal you some minutes right now. 44-35, Wasatch making runs here at the end of quarters and halves.
They have hit you with that spurt ability that's made them good, and that's the reason why they were back-to-back Geico national participants.
Watch SUV TV whenever and wherever you want. Streaming live and on demand on Amazon Fire TV, Roku TV, Apple TV, and Android TV. Visit watchsuvtv.com to watch full game broadcast replays and select original content. 2 minutes to go, 44-35. Unable to get the three-point play. Green drives. Oh, Sissoko is volleyballing stuff out of there. He got it, outlet it, and now here they come in transition now to Colomero. Colomero over, open, three. Williams, no. Rebound, Watkins Causey, who had to come back into the game. Benjamin has it. Picked up by Williams. He crosses the timeline with 95 seconds to go, first half. An entertaining first half. We told you Wasatch likes to score. Blessed, three. Oh,
that's a big three right there. Huge three from Meadowcreek.
Off the bench into the scorebook. Corey Blessed. Open. Richie Saunders. Hill of the rim, no. Rebound Sissoko. He's going to have 50 of them by the night over. Williams, a deep three. Get it out of the bottom of the net. Marvin Trey Williams the third. Affectionately, a third. And it's Trey. Trey.
They are making this thing look really easy with that extra pass.
Deep three, NBA range three, 47-38.
There's a reason why he's going to Minnesota.
Yeah, to shoot in the Great Lake.
I'm telling you.
47-38, or the land of 10,000 lakes, whatever it is in Minnesota.
He's
going to
have fun shooting in the barn, I tell you that.
I know that's right.
That's
man.
A great shooter's gym. I should know. Been in there a few times.
The barn is, yeah. Some places, kind of like Memorial Gymnasium in Nashville, you like shooting in them. Trey Williams is shooting them from everywhere. I wonder if he can shoot them out there on Oaks Course. Attention all golfers, experience the Oaks Course in Covington, Georgia, home of superb greens and friendly tees. The Oaks Course is open every day except Christmas and is located at 11240 Brown Bridge Road in Covington, Georgia, 30014. Visit GolfOaks.com or call 770-786-3801. Mention SGB TV for a discount on your round. Out of the timeout, Kendrick Green has it. That timeout was charged to Wasatch Academy. Both teams with 18 fouls. Green across the timeline. He'll set it up. 1 minute to go. First half in what has been a very entertaining first half. Wasatch averages 91 points per game. They're right on that mark now so far.
You ready, Kendrick?
Open. Green, right wing, three. Hill of the rim, no. Rebound to Sissoko. Sissoko swallowing up the glass. Williams, one way and the other with the dribble. Now he gives it over to Colomero. Colomero now to Saunders. Open, Richie Saunders, a three. No, front iron. Rebound comes off to Blessed. They're stealing minutes with Corey Blessed off the bench. Here's Benjamin. Benjamin calls out the set. Half minute to go. Second quarter.
What a great game up and down. This has been a quick quarter right here. A lot of firepower on both sides.
Benjamin now will hand it off to Green. They'll start the offense. Green going to drive. Green now in the corner. Not there. Out of bounds. A turnover. Benjamin wasn't ready for the pass. Green now taps himself on the head and says, my bad.
And Wasatch's size and their length and their athleticism is really affecting Meadowcreek right now.
Saunders drives, open to Sissoko, shoulder range, short, rebound on the floor, and that will be the end of a very, very, very entertaining first quarter. It's Holiday Hoopsgiving. What would you expect? And it's exclusively on SUV TV. Wasatch Academy with a 47-38 lead. It is Utah leading Georgia. Wasatch out of Utah. Meadowcreek out of Georgia. Second half coming up in just a moment right here. The fifth anniversary of Holiday Hoopsgiving.
This SUV TV presentation of Holiday Hoopsgiving is brought to you by Adidas, East Bay, Children's Healthcare of Atlanta, The Oaks Course, The Atlanta Tip-Off Club.
What is it about some places? The places where we feel a sense of fellowship, where service is of the highest priority, whether to each other or to ourselves. A journey familiar like a warm bath for the soul. Along the way, we may get lost, but we always seem to find a friendly hand reaching out, guiding us the way back there, where we owe it to our younger selves. Just to feel like we're getting a little bit better at us. This place will always be there for you. This place is sacred. Because this place is home.
Heels or flats?
Heels.
Around here, we're decision-making pros. But when she got injured last season, I almost made the wrong decision. I thought I could take her where I rehabbed my knee. But her coach told me, take her to Children's. No thanks. All that experience helped my daughter heal faster and come back stronger.
Now we just need to decide where I'll play in college.
Road trip.
Williamson makes his way around one tight. dribbling it toward the lane and throws it down. That's what the crowd had been waiting on. A fantastic dunk coming in by Williamson.
Trent, off balance jumper.
Nailed it. Pierre to Gary Trent Jr. And oh my goodness, that's how you end the game, folks.
Watch SUV TV whenever and wherever you want, streaming live and on demand on Amazon Fire TV, Roku TV, Apple TV, and Android TV. Visit watchsgvtv.com to watch full game broadcast replays and select original content. Back here at the half, Joel Hillsman and Lewis Preston. Meadowcreek and Wasatch Academy. Wasatch with a 47-38 lead. But Coach Preston, we have got a lot to get into in this contest. Looking at the stat sheet, some of the things that stand out to me, Meadowcreek 58% field goal shooting. Meadowcreek 58%, Wasatch 54%. But then you look over, both teams have 7 assists. Each of them have 14 plus made field goals. What's the difference right now here at the half of the game?
Very simply, it's the second chance points, which is 16-0 right now in favor of Wasatch, as well as the bench scoring, 16-3 in favor of Wasatch. Once again, their size and then their depth with their ability to bring in young man like Richie Saunders coming off and being a flamethrower for Wasatch Academy.
Taking a look at some of the first half highlights there, a flamethrower Richie Saunders is. He has 14 of the 16 points off the bench, which makes Corey Blessed's three for Meadowcreek even big. That gives them their bench points. Both teams playing 7 players, but the key factor, we talked about it, Wasatch has a size advantage. Meadowcreek, Watkins Causey has 3 fouls. Jameer Chaplin has 3 fouls. That's really the hype for Meadowcreek.
Exactly, and once again, it'll be interesting to see what Coach Gillian does with some of his different rotations, different matchups here to start this third quarter, because you can't afford for Causey or Chaplin to pick up that 4th foul.
Just looking at some other stats, 7 turnovers for Meadowcreek, 5 turnovers for Wasatch. I mentioned the assists, 7 assists on 17 made field goals for Wasatch, 7 assists on 14 made field goals for Meadowcreek. The difference is the second chance opportunities, and that goes to the height advantage.
Exactly. And once again, it's not just Sissoko. It is Trey Williams' size. It is De Silva coming off the bench with his size. It's Anurano, his size as well. Once again, their size has been very effective for them to build up and get this 9-point lead as we start the third quarter.
Plus 7 on the glass, 17-10 Wasatch. Again, leaning toward that glass. Sissoko, 8 boards to lead Wasatch.
Yes, but of those 17 rebounds, 8 of them are offensive.
Yep, and that's led to 16 points. So basically, if you break it down, they're scoring off of every offensive rebound.
Exactly.
If you break it down by average. That's what we do. The second half is underway. Jalen Benjamin will bring it across for Meadowcreek. They're all in white, white tops, white bottoms, white numbers, Columbia trim. Done. Open 3. Skipped off the rim. No good. Rebound comes off to Wasatch and Williams. Williams to Sissoko. They play pitch and catch. Mike Saunders is out there. They dump it down low. And a foul, offensive foul called on Maddie Sissoko.
That's a great job right there by Chaplin stepping in, but that would have been his 4th potentially right there. So
Bernardo da Silva gets the start again, the 6'9 player out of Rio de Janeiro. You've had some fun down there, haven't you?
Oh, boy. Carnival.
I'm trying to tell you. Benjamin Chaplin, Watkins Causey, Dunn, and Collier, the foul on the floor that started for Meadowcreek. They're in possession. Williams, Sissoko, Inaranyu, da Silva, and Mike Saunders, the foul on the floor for Wasatch. Done, 14-footer. No, back tap comes off. Mike Saunders has it. He's turning it on a gear. Over to Williams. Williams, a 3. Hill of the rim, no. Rebound comes off. Inaranyu. Inaranyu goes up, Tristan, and scores.
It goes back to that size that we talked about. Once again, second chance points, right? Second, they're 9-for-9 in second chance points, 18 points.
49-38 in the lead. All of a sudden, it's up to 11. Benjamin drives, left his feet in the air, open. Now gives it out. Chaplin, 3 ball. Good. Good extra pass from Emmanuel Caller.
Sharing is carrying, as you like to say. That's a huge 3 for Meadowcreek right there.
Yeah, it keeps it now down to 8, 49-41. A very high-level ball game. What would you expect? It's Holiday Hoopsgiving. It's on SUV TV. Joel Hillsman, Lewis Preston, glad that you're with us. 90 seconds into this third quarter. On the back, turning offensive foul will be called. He didn't like it, but Tristan on around you with the offensive foul.
You should be behind him. You should be in front of him.
They got lucky right there a little bit with that right there. I'll tell you that. These refs have done a very good job in regards to this game with this activity and this high level of activity.
Yes, they have. Benjamin Benjamin one way and the other, bounces it in the corner, open Collier, corner pocket three!
Back-to-back threes by Meadowcreek right there to get him right back into this game. 5-point lead for Wasatch.
They have shot the three ball exceptionally well. They hit six in the first half. Wasatch hit eight. Pass is deflected and stolen. Chaplin got the deflection. Benjamin recovers it. Here comes Benjamin. He's worked on by Williams between the rings. He'll bring it back out. Wasatch and Meadowcreek buckle up in Hoopsgiving action in Atlanta. Back stop. Benjamin, jumper, no. Rebound comes off Tristan Arana, who gives it over to Saunders. Here comes Saunders. Saunders skipping to Malou. Stops. There's an elbow jumper from 16. No good. Rebound hit the floor and picked up out of the guard spot is Jalen Benjamin. Benjamin now surveys and probes back to the middle. Now skips it back to Dunn. Dunn hesitates. Going to drive. Put it up with the right hand and score. Damian Dunn.
Damian Dunn is absolutely a stat sheet stuffer.
It was 11 just a minute ago. That's an 8-0 run for Meadowcreek. 49-46, 5:25 to go. Williams gives it to Saunders. He's picked up defensively by Benjamin. Sissoko has it. Turns. Jump hook fading away is short. Rebound out of the guard spot comes Benjamin. They're going to try to push it. Here's Benjamin now. Benjamin on the right side. Stop. Pull up. Three. Transition. In and out. No. Rebound in Aranu. He went up and swatted down Big Tristan in Aranu. Now he gives it over to Williams. Williams hesitates. He works. Drives up. Sit and out. Get down. Beat down block from behind by Jameer Chaplin. Chaplin gives it over to Dunn.
He had to return that to Sunder right there.
Remember, Chaplin and Watkins Causey each playing with three fouls. Oh, beautiful pass, blown layup at the rim. That's 2 points. You might want to write that down. 4:47 in the third quarter. A blown easy bunny layup there. Wow. If the game comes down to 2 points, there it was. There they were right there.
Especially when points are at a premium.
Very much so. They may be at a premium, but you got to remember Wasatch averages 91. So they want to try and break the scoreboard on you every night. Lost it. A turnover. So they don't get the hoop, and then they turn it over on the reprieve. 49-46. Inaranu. Inaranu drive. Carry. A traveling violation. Tristan Inaranu out of the Netherlands. It is a full timeout. The full timeout. David Evans takes it for Wasatch Academy. Glad that you are with us wherever you are. The SUVTV.com. The Atlanta Tip-Off Club annually recognizes the top high school and college players, coaches, officials, and administrators in Metro Atlanta and the state of Georgia. Join the ATOC, nominate players and coaches, or learn more at www.ATLTipOffClub.com. New coaches, mention SUVTV. When you sign up to receive 10% off of your season membership, Joel Hilsman, Lewis Preston, glad that you're with us. We have a doozy right here. Wasatch Academy out of Mount Pleasant, Utah, and Meadowcreek Mustangs out of Norcross, Georgia, 49-46. We currently are in the middle of an 8-0 Meadowcreek run with 4.5 to go, hence the Wasatch Academy timeout, Coach.
Well, first of all, Coach Evans has got to tell his team to slow down and everything and just keep making the extra pass. As for Meadowcreek, Coach Gillian is just, hey, once again, they have forced the tempo of this game, and their defense has led to some easy offense for them in this third quarter.
Taking a look there at Emmanuel Collier hitting that three. Meadowcreek coming in at 3-0. Wasatch coming in at 3-0 as well. Across the timeline, it is Benjamin. Benjamin picked up by Saunders. He spins it over to Dunn, now hands it to Kedrick Green, who checked in. Green will seek you and find you. There's a drop down. Chaplin can't get it. They're down there fighting for it. Sissoko has it, and he comes away with it. Sissoko's been on the floor more than the floor itself. Here comes Saunders. Saunders wanted to step into the three. It wasn't there. So Inaranu has it. He's got the height advantage on Green, but Green, good lateral movement, wouldn't let him go. And a foul called on Emmanuel Collier. Foul called on Emmanuel Collier, who has been bombing triples in this contest. He has two threes.
Could have called that original hook right there down low on Inaranu.
Let's see who's the foul going to be on. Offensive foul called on Trey Williams.
Oh, wow.
Marvin Williams III, officially known as Trey, picks up his second foul.
Very interesting call right there.
Hey, 77. 8 3-pointers hit in the contest for Meadowcreek, 8 for Wasatch. Wasatch right now only 2 points here in this second half so far, and we played halfway gone here in this third quarter, 3:55. Here's Damian Dunn. Dunn to Green. Green with his head up, right-hand dribble, spins it to the left, now to Benjamin. Benjamin stops, pulls a three, bottoms, get it out the bottom of the net. Wow. Jalen Benjamin, a three ball, and we're tied. 49 all, 11-0 run.
Exactly. Said that, took the words right out of my mouth, Joel.
Inside goes baseline, and they're calling a foul on Kedrick Green, the young sophomore. Well, a valuable experience sophomore.
Exactly. State champion sophomore.
I think the only thing Kedrick needs to work on now maybe is his scoring production. There's Wick. Get this shot out of here. Jameer Chaplin, another beatdown block.
That's what he does, right?
Sending it away. That's the size, though. Here comes Imani Watkins. Causey going to check in now. And they're going to give Collier a bench. Chaplin and Watkins Causey each playing with three fouls, Coach.
I love it. I love this activity. I love this energy right now. You can feel it. It's palpable in the gym.
Looks, he gives it to Sissoko. Sissoko comes, and now he hands it over to Williams. Williams in the air, and the pass was stolen by Chaplin. Here comes Dunn. Damian Dunn on the break. Damian going all the way up. He was fouled. It'll go to the free throw line. Meadowcreek has battled back from being down 11 and tied it, and they've held this high-flying, explosive offense of Wasatch to only 2 points in the third quarter.
Once again, when you are a championship-level team and you have a championship coach, you are able to withstand runs.
Damian Dunn coming off a 22-point outing earlier this week against Tequila at the free throw line now. Free throw is good for Damian Dunn. Dunn also had 26 in the season opener against Wheeler.
It's a 12-0 run right now by Meadowcreek.
It was 49-38, in case you were wondering. Free throw, done. He made them both. They have came to absolute life. They're on the plus side. Lead has changed hands 7 times in this contest. 51-49, Meadowcreek on defense now with the lead. Oh, Williams played with the dribble, goes to Saunders. Saunders skip. Uh-oh, here comes that sniper, Richie Saunders, and a foul called on Green. I don't believe that one. Yeah, I'm going to agree with the Meadowcreek bench, not because they're closer to me, but because they just stated fact that wasn't being called earlier. Now gets it in to Sissoko. Sissoko's a cutting Williams layup. Good. They ran that beautiful out of bounds play, Coach.
It's a nice play right there. Just a little give and go. Little give and go action.
That ends the 12-0 run. 51-51. I'm telling you, wherever 15 is, whoever's guarding him, stay in his chops. He can shoot it. There's a float by Benjamin up. Offensive foul call on Jim Benjamin.
Where you got to be able to pull up for that nice little short J right there.
Yeah. The Tony Parker floater?
Yeah. Just got to go straight up and down. Can't be moving.
Coach, we got to talk about Mike Saunders. He hasn't had a lot of scoring, 8 points, but he's been conducting the offense on and off the ball. Saunders drives across the lane. He stopped, gives it back. A traveling violation call, so I bring him up with praise on a turnover. Emmanuel Collier checks in. Kedrick Green will take a seat.
This is like watching a great boxing match right now. How you counter, how you make some moves, how you take blows, how you get back up. Great, great game.
51-51. Chaplin has it. It was poked away, and he came in and got the steal. Saunders, no. Benjamin recovers it. Benjamin out of Kingston, North Carolina, crosses the timeline with a right-hand dribble. He calls out the set, and they'll run it. Here comes the screen from Watkins Causey, one way and the other. Now he's got the switch with Sissoko. He's got the defense. Oh, good job down there battling to get back in front, Watkins Causey. Benjamin, pull up, three, bottom. Oh, Jalen Benjamin is on absolute fire. Give me the hot sauce. Give me the hot sauce. Jalen Benjamin, that's his fourth triple of the day. Drive, Saunders, no offensive foul.
He kept his body in front of him, and he lowered the shoulder. That's a great call right there. But for Jalen Benjamin right there to set up Sissoko for that three-point shot, beautiful stuff right there, beautiful stuff.
I was just looking down at Coach Evans shaking his head. They've only scored 2 points in this quarter, wondering how much he could take it. He calls a timeout. At Children's Healthcare of Atlanta, the sports medicine team doesn't just treat the pain for sports injuries. They work with young athletes to fix the problem and teach them proper sports mechanics. When you choose Children's, you're in the hands of specialists who understand how to help young athletes get back in the game. Visit choa.org/sportsman to learn more. Taking a look there, beautiful driving layup off the left hand with Marvin Trey Williams III. But, man, they only have 4 points, Coach, in this third quarter. That's after a 24-point first quarter, a 23-point second quarter.
But what did we talk about at the beginning of the game? What did we say about Meadowcreek? The best rotation defensive team in the state, bar none. I'll argue with anybody, anytime, anywhere, any day.
And they are known to allow fewer points as the game progresses. We've seen that twice this year.
And we're going to see it for a third time, potentially.
Benjamin gives it in and a foul reach in there by Trey Williams. That's big. That's his third now with 1:24 to go. This is the same Meadowcreek team minus the height that played Paul the Six to an overtime. Now, you know how I feel about Paul the Six and WCAC basketball. That ain't no shabby squad to lose to with Jeremy Roach and Brandon Slater and Anthony Harris on that team.
And Glenn Ferrello is one of the best WCAC coaches, as well. He might arguably be one of the best coaches around.
I'm going to give you that. He picked up his 1,000th win right here on SUV TV last year at the Tournament of Champions. Drive done. Up off the window. No. Richie Saunders goes up and gets the board. So he rebounds. He fires threes. And he does well defensively. There's Inuanu. Inuanu goes back out. Saunders pitch and catch. Oh, good ball movement. Williams open short. Three ball. Rebound hit the floor. Williams got it back. Gave it up off the window. Tristan Inuanu.
When we go back and look at the final stats of this game, offensive rebounds, second chance points are going to be something we go back as a key factor.
Inuanu with that hoop. 54-53. Under a minute. Third quarter. Can we play 12 minutes in the fourth? Benjamin screen. No. Offensive foul call on Emmanuel Collier. Coach Curtis Gillian upset. Slaps his hands together. 54-53. This going to come down to coaching and talent. I'm going to tell you that. The talent is there and the coaching is there.
I love late game situations potentially here.
Came around and now Richie Saunders worked on defensively by Collier. Meadowcreek is going to play you defensively. Look at the defense. They've allowed 4 points in this, 6 points in the quarter. Open jumper. This guy just shoots fish in a barrel.
I'm telling you.
Richie Saunders, the jump good. Still 8 points in the quarter, though. They've got the lead, 55-54. Benjamin now picked up his dribble. He gives it to Chaplin with three, with two. Watkins calls it with a dunk.
Wow.
His first field goal. And what a third quarter by the Meadowcreek Mustangs. Wasatch Academy held to 8 points in that quarter. Wasatch is good. Meadowcreek is good. This game will be better. 56-55, Meadowcreek over Wasatch. We'll be back for the fourth quarter in just a moment. SUV TV.
Heels or flats?
Heels.
Around here, we're decision-making pros. But when she got injured last season, I almost made the wrong decision. I thought I could take her where I rehabbed my knee. But her coach told me, take her to Children's. No thanks. All that experience helped my daughter heal faster and come back stronger.
Now we just need to decide where I'll play in college.
Road trip.
Every time we open our doors, we change just a little bit. Every blade of grass, every rose petal, every pen location. But the one thing that doesn't change is our commitment to an exceptional golfing experience. Being prepared to give it our all 364 days a year is not just a credo. It's our soul.
The fourth quarter is underway. I'm sorry we got back a little late. I had to go find a seatbelt. Joe Hillsman, Lewis Preston, I can't even get it buckled. And there goes Tristan Arano showing the range. A three ball is good. 58-56. It was 56-55 when we started the quarter. I'm Joe Hillsman. He's Lewis Preston. Wasatch and Meadowcreek. Both of them still, Coach Preston, are shooting over 50%.
He's your Green with a nice reverse layup right there.
Green off the bench and gets his first field goal. He has a couple of assists. And we're tied at 58. Matter of fact, I have him with three assists, and the book has him with three assists. I'm on point. Everybody's got to be on point with this. There goes Richie Saunders. Stop. Picked up the dribble. Green got in his mug. Sissoko turns it. Pitches it back out to Marvin Williams. Williams now has had himself a pretty effective day as well. He has 19 points to lead Wasatch. Mike Saunders, three. Side iron, no. Rebound out of the guard spot, Jalen Benjamin. Benjamin now going to drive. Skip to Malou. Took contact and scored. Jalen Benjamin seeking and finding the contact, taking it and going off the window. And the lead goes back the other way. 10 lead changes now. 60-58. 11 lead changes now.
I'm going to tell everybody right now, you better go more than buckle up. It's going to be a special ride.
Saunders up, lost it out of bounds. Good defense. I'm also going to applaud Jameer Chaplin and Jamani Watkins-Causey. Each of them still with only three fouls. Kendrick Green has three as well.
High IQ basketball players right there for them not to get that fourth foul. Very important going into the fourth quarter.
Mike Saunders in the paint over to Richie Saunders. Richie got to the elbow jumper. It rolled off. No. Rebound again out of the guard spot in Jalen Benjamin. Benjamin now with five boards. And when you're small like Meadowcreek, if you have good rebounding guards, it's going to keep you in a lot of ball games, hence the result
well,
now.
One of the great things about the smart thing with Chaplin and Causey not getting their fourth foul, they get to get their size back.
Dunn falling down. Pass was deflected by Williams. Chaplin tipped it. Dunn has it. Tried to get it into Watkins Causey. Good hands from Sissoko. Now Williams run the floor. Sissoko dunk. Slam dunk on the break. Matty Sissoko, he has four. Even and a timeout call, a full timeout call by the Meadowcreek Mustangs with 5:42 to go. SUV TV instant replay time. We're tied at 60. Attention all golfers. Experience the Oaks Course in Covington, Georgia, home of superb greens and friendly tees. The Oaks Course is open every day except Christmas and is located at 11240 Brown Bridge Road in Covington, Georgia, 30014. Visit golfoaks.com or call 770-786-3801. Mention SUV TV for a discount on your round. Joe Hillsman, Lewis Preston, glad that you're with us. SUV TV's coverage of the 5th anniversary Holiday Hoopsgiving brought to you by the Oaks Course, Children's Healthcare of Atlanta, and Atlanta Tip-Off Club.
One of the things that's been really impressive with both of these teams are how they've withstood each other's runs. And it goes to tell you right there that these are championship caliber programs that have a great culture, because most people would have folded. They've just withstood them, stayed true to who they are, and that's the reason why with 5:42 left, we have a tie game at 60 apiece.
And we always say it's no question about it. It's not an opinion. It's a fact. Basketball is a game of runs. 12-0 run for Wasatch to end the first. A 12-0 run for Meadowcreek to open the third. That type of stuff happens in basketball. Saunders knocked it away.
That was a nice backdoor cut right there by Jameer Chaplin. Luckily right there, Saunders was able to get that kick right there.
So now
Chaplin with the air ball right there.
So now here's Saunders. Saunders. Now he gives it down. Here's Tristan Aranahu. Tristan turns up. Oh, Chaplin picked up the fourth foul.
Not sure about that one right there. Not sure.
Gotta play that sound. Wall them up on that. Yeah.
His fourth foul right there, right?
Yes, that's Chaplin's fourth foul.
Okay. Got to see how we finish this thing down the stretch.
Tristan's free throw is good. Tristan Inaranhu. 61-60. Second free throw, no good. Chase down, offensive rebound. Three ball. Off. No. Rebound comes off now. And here's outletting Chaplin to Benjamin. Jalen Benjamin now will come. Benjamin going to skip. Goes behind the back. Benjamin across the lane. He dumped it off to Watkins-Causey. He's not there. Watkins-Causey shoots it over. Ball knocked out of bounds. We talked about second chance points, Coach. 20-0 Wasatch Academy second chance points. Off the bench, 18-3. But it was Meadowcreek being able to uplift the scoring and hold down with their defense, which allowed them to have the lead after three quarters.
Only, I mean, being able for them to only score 8 points, turnover right here.
William Steele. William goes up and scores. Trey Williams.
Trey Williams doing what Trey Williams does best. Willing and dealing.
63-60, 3-point game. Dunn now takes it and gives it to Jalen Benjamin. Benjamin picked up by Mike Saunders. Now he gives it over to Dunn, who came on a semi-Iverson cut. Gives it back now to Benjamin. Benjamin now, jab step, goes around the screen. Both of them came out. Somebody's open. Benjamin swings it to Dunn. Dunn puts it on the floor. Dunn drives, left hand up off the window. No. And a foul call.
Foul right there on Sissoko right there. Really interesting right here with the different, with how, once again, Wasatch just came back with that little bit of a run, their mini run, as I like to call it, to take and get that 3-point lead. We'll be curious to see here with Don with these free throws, how Meadowcreek's going to be able to answer with 4:19 left with Jameer Chaplin with four fouls.
Damian Dunn at the free throw line. He's 2 of 2 on the day, and the first one is good, so he's 3 of 3. 63-61. Dunn will get one more. 4:19 to go. Free throw, good. 63-62. Now here's Mike Saunders. Saunders across the timeline. Now he gives it over to Richie Saunders. Gives it to Williams. Williams worked on defensively by Dunn. Gets the screen. Williams jumped it off to Sissoko. He caught it and gave it back to Tristan Inarano. Tristan, one way in the other. Chaplin's got four fouls. Richie left his feet. Saunders drives. Saunders goes up. Took contact. Good job. Floor to the ceiling. No foul call. Rebound comes off to Damian Dunn.
Great job right there by Meadowcreek, making him having to shoot a tough layup, which he wasn't able to finish.
Man, I'm going to tell you something. Wasatch Academy is a fun, fun basketball team, man. I'm loving them. And what Sissoko is bringing to them is just valuable. It's on the floor. Look at that. He should be wearing knee pads. Did he slide out of bounds? He did not. Coach David Evans calls a 30-second timeout. 3:33 to go. It is 63-62. Wasatch has a 1-point lead. Wasatch just used their final timeout. They are out of timeouts with 3:33 to go. That's big there.
So right now we're 3.5 minutes to go. Wasatch is out of timeouts. Meadowcreek has three.
Three timeouts for Meadowcreek. Wasatch, no timeouts.
Some of those quick timeouts there in the first half might come back to haunt them here late game.
Really, 3:33 to go the rest of the way. That is a clear advantage to Meadowcreek.
Clear.
And you've got three timeouts, but now you don't even want to call your timeouts to give them to regroup.
That's a great point. That's a great point. You don't want them to catch a breather.
No. A breather or strategic.
Or to get rotations in. Exactly.
You want them to be have to do everything within the flow of the game.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay. And they're making sure, they're reminding all the players there are no timeouts. And Coach Evans was like, I swear I had two timeouts left. Now he's confused. He may question that now.
Yeah,
he didn't know he didn't have any timeouts left.
Right. He still thought he had two left.
Yeah, he did. He thought he had two left. He sure did.
He's not coming down to the bench or coming down to the scores table at all.
He's not questioning. Yeah. I don't think yet. No, they're going to – they're wiping up something. 63-62, 3:33 to go.
He's going to have to reach deep into his coaching bag of tricks.
Wasatch Academy out of timeouts. That's the story now. 3:30 to go. They're in possession. They got a 1-point lead. Hands it over to Tristan Inarano. Inarano going to drive. There's an alley there. This is a goal. Sissoko, just big, valuable points.
That's beautiful big man to big man lob.
That's the best kind of lob. Wasatch bringing the fire and the noise. Here comes Benjamin. Benjamin now's got Sissoko. Sissoko wants him. He's clapping his hands defensively. So he's going to pull a three. No, hill of the rim. Rebound off the right Saunders. Saunders protects it, lets it, gets through the traffic, and he'll bring it across the timeline under 3 minutes to go. Wasatch in the black with the orange numbers. Meadowcreek all in white. Wasatch with a three-point lead. Open three ball. No. Rebound long. Another second chance opportunity. Here's Williams. Williams wants that screen from Sissoko. Gets it. Goes baseline. Drives. Left his feet. Mike Saunders. Open three online. Bottom. Mike Saunders, a big-time triple.
We went back and said earlier those second chance points is going to come back and potentially be a huge factor, in which it is, with 2:20 to go.
23 to nothing in second chance opportunities, in second chance points. Foul call on Saunders. Free throws the rest of the way. Oh, offensive foul called on Kendrick Green. Holy smokes. How is that an offensive foul, Mr. Ref? Oh, whoo. We're right here looking at it. Wow.
I'm just going to shake my head on that one because there's a lot more I want to say, but you know what? Still 2:10 left to go in the game.
Green hit with his fourth foul. Saunders drives over to Sissoko. Sissoko goes up. He walked with the basketball.
That's a makeup call.
No, it's not. It's four fouls on Green. That's what that is.
Yeah, but he made
because
up on
that foul should have sent Green to the free throw.
Oh, I totally agree with you.
Free throws the rest of the way. 2 minutes. Fourth quarter. Kendrick Green has it between the rings. He's worked on by Richie Saunders. Hands it off to Jalen Benjamin. Jalen Benjamin has had himself a night. You hear me? 23 points in the game so far. And a five count turnover. Back-to-back offensive turnovers for Meadowcreek in a key stretch of the game.
Was he closely guarded right there?
68-62.
Okay. You moving on, tell me my exact answer.
100 seconds to go. Man, this has been a great game. Awesome. But you know what? Wasatch comes in 91 points per game. You wasn't going to get that against Meadowcreek. The defense is just too strong. Son Williams drives, flying out of control. Blocking foul call. Foul called on Jamani Watkins calls. He has picked up his fourth. So Chaplin with four, Green with four, and Watkins calls it with four. 68-62, 89 seconds.
What a high-level game we've had. We've been entertained here today.
6 points from Meadowcreek here in this quarter, though. They held Wasatch to eight in the third quarter. They had back-to-back 18-point scoring quarters. Williams free throw, good. And they've done a lot of it with the long ball. 10 three-pointers in the game, so 30 points of their 62 have been from beyond the arc. And they've done it at the free throw line as well, 66%. Second free throw from Williams, no good. Out of bounds, and it will go to Wasatch Academy. Mm. So Wasatch right now, 7-point lead. They may have the final run to end what has been a fabulous played basketball game. Looking, gets it in. Williams kicks it back to Tristan and Aronu. We put it on the floor. Now to Mike Saunders. They'll start eating some of that clock now. Saunders down the right of the lane to Sissoko. Sissoko turns, shot, fade off, no. Rebound comes off, they got to push it. 70 seconds. Benjamin now shovels it to Chaplin, who dunked it and was fouled from behind. Jameer Chaplin, is he all right? Yeah, he's all right. They're going to get him on. Up, he'll go to the free throw line.
I thought he was going to finish that one right there.
Chaplin with 16 points in the contest. 23 from Jalen Benjamin.
Jameer Chaplin at the line shooting two.
Chaplin at the line, trailing by seven. But the thing is, they get fouls now. They can shoot free throws. Free throw, Chaplin, up it and good.
Come on, get up, everybody. Jane Watkins causing. Checks back in with the Mustangs.
One more. Do you start playing the foul game right now, Coach?
I think
front iron, no.
I think you got to extend it as much as possible.
And they're in the 1-1 right now, so it plays to your advantage. 1 minute, fourth quarter. 6-point game, trying to get a 5 count and a foul. It'll go to the free throw line. I'm not mad about that foul. The foul count, the refs have been very good. Just a questionable call last tough couple, but other than that, it's been all right.
Yeah, very good game.
Emmanuel Collier will come in. Jabani Watkins. So this is offense for defense now from Coach Curtis Gilliam. Coming up next here, court one, gym one. Free throw is good from Saunders. It will be Greater Atlanta Christian taking on Wheeler. Second free throw from Saunders is good. Saunders stuck some big free throws right there, Coach Preston.
Stuck some huge ones right there, making it a three-possession game right now.
71-63, done, open three, in and out, no, rebound tip. Wasatch length, Wasatch second chance points. Man, this is a good basketball team. Foul call by Dunn on the floor.
They sure are, definitely.
They have just about a little of everything. You know that's what you need to make a run, a little bit of everything. Coach Gillian still out here coaching them up. 38-8, 10 seconds. Saunders going back to the free throw line. He is 4 of 5 on the day from the stripe. Good. 72-63.
Hey, this is a statement for Wasatch to come from Utah here to Georgia to the Very Holiday much. Hoops game, given to come out 2-0.
And sweep.
Yes.
Free throw, good. They've been to Geico now in 2016 and 2017. They have what it takes. There's a drive by Dunn in the corner. Now the Collier floats it up and in good, and a timeout quickly called. You know what? Coach Evans wasn't really worried about that timeout situation. That was 3 minutes ago when we thought it might have been a factor. It was not. Coach David Evans' squad is very, very good. They're looking at 4-0.
But once again, when you have a veteran group that, once again, when your culture's right and you have a championship pedigree and you've been to Geico, you can handle 3:33 left to go in the game with no timeouts and still figure out a way to come out on top.
26-6, 10 seconds. It'll be Greater Atlanta Christian and Wheeler coming up next right here on SUV TV's exclusive coverage of Holiday Hoopsgiving, the 5th anniversary, here from Holy Innocence Episcopal School in Atlanta, Georgia. So it'll be inbound, baseline, looks and gives it in to Williams. Williams to Sissoko. They want to get the foul quickly. Yeah, he's who you should have fouled. 21 seconds. I think they maybe should have started playing the foul game a little earlier, right at that 1 minute mark. Foul given, that'll be Kedrick Green, I think, with the foul, and if it is, that'll be his 5th. Yep, Green will just foul out. Kedrick Green, sophomore, he'll foul out with 2 points, 3 assists. Manuel Collier will be checking in. Watkins Causey going out.
Second shot.
Nope. Yeah, he'll have to come back in. Kedrick will foul out. Future very bright for that young sophomore.
Though. Man, you have no idea. So bright we gotta wear shades, don't we?
Free throw. Good from Richie Saunders, who, you know, we came in talking about Trey Williams, but man, I think Richie Saunders literally came off that bench and saved them in this game.
I'm going to tell you this right now. I already texted a couple of my buddies out there on the college circuit.
I like me some Richie Saunders.
I like flamethrowers.
All day. Benjamin, a bevy of moves, takes contact. He hadn't quit playing, goes and gets the foul. Still, though, a testament to Meadowcreek's defense. Wasatch averaging 91 points per game. They're going to hold them well below that, almost 15, 16 points below right now at 75 points. And it also shows that Meadowcreek can push the pace and play with a national team. I like it. I like this Wasatch Academy team. No, man, do I like them.
I'm going to tell you right now, if I'm Georgia coaches right now, I'm very worried about Meadowcreek because you know what? They look like they got the potential to be back-to-back.
Surely can. They took a tough loss to Paul to 6 last year, still won the state championship. Going to take a tough loss here to this Utah squad, which is not your average Utah squad, right, but still.
Some high-level bodies out here on both sides of the ball. College coaches should be salivating.
They are. They're sitting courtside. I saw you in between games with your notepad out.
Yeah, I'm always taking notes now. Always taking notes.
That will be the end of the contest. Wasatch Academy comes to Hoopsgiving and wins their two games, one over a South Carolina school and one over a Georgia school. Final score, Wasatch Academy 76, Meadowcreek 67. Meadowcreek, nothing to hang their hats about here. Wasatch Academy is very, very good. Look for them down the road as their schedule is absolutely loaded. I'm just getting the quick tallies for you right quick. A 20-point fourth quarter from Wasatch after Meadowcreek held them to 8. So you have to really do that math right there, 8, 9, 11 points for Meadowcreek in the second quarter. So final tally, let's see, Williams is going to finish with 22. Mike Saunders is going to finish with 15. Richie Saunders, 14, 16, 18 points. 14 of those 18 in the first half. Wasatch Academy and Meadowcreek, both of them shot the basketball extremely well. Wasatch Academy 49%, Meadowcreek 54%, but coach, the second chance points 23-0, the bench points 20-5 in favor of Wasatch Academy.
And nothing else needs to be said except for the fact that Richie Saunders scored 18 of those 20 bench points right there. He was the difference maker in this game.
Also, 12 assists on 26 made field goals for Wasatch, 10 assists on 23 made field goals for Meadowcreek.
Right.
Great Atlanta Christian and Wheeler coming up next. Lewis Preston, Joel Hillsman will be back with you here on exclusive coverage of Holiday Hoopsgiving, the 5th anniversary on SUV TV.